Welcome to another episode of Caution Under Fire. Today we will be reviewing Ruger's SR9C. This is the little brother of their SR9 full size. The C stands for compact, obviously. This one's new in box, just got it a little bit ago. Got it from my employer, actually, for job well done and whatnot, so that was kind of nice. I bought one of these, probably about a year ago. Really enjoyed it, but the problem was I needed some money, so I ended up selling it. And so I got this one, and I've enjoyed it too, but once again, I'm selling it. That's not in any way to cast a discrepancy against this gun. I want to say that right off the bat. The gun itself actually performs very well. It has been chamber checked. This gun comes with a box, test fired round. It's got a lock with it, all the fun little things. But the one thing about this gun, the SR9C, is that the slide is going to be slightly shorter than the regular SR9. It's made to be more compact. Now, as you notice, I just dropped this mag. This is a 17-round mag. This actually will fit in the standard SR9. So the SR9 mags work with this gun just fine. But then it's got a sleeve extension on it, and that allows you to get the full-size grip off of your gun, which is actually rather nice, I think. So when you're out practicing or whatnot, it gives you some good options. This gun also comes with a 10-round magazine. It comes with two base plates. It comes with this pinky extension one, so if you've got a larger hand, this gives you a nice grip so your pinky doesn't hang off. It also comes with just a flat base plate extension that you can switch it out with. So if you want to, you know, have it more flush, because this can actually print if you're carrying this gun concealed. This will stick out a little bit more than the flush one, so that's the purpose behind that. Now, when I've carried this gun personally, not this one, but the previous one, I would actually carry it with the 10-rounder so that it wouldn't imprint as much. I did use the pinky extension because it does give me a little bit better grip on it. And then I would actually carry the 17-round mag in an empty Leatherman holster on my side. This way I actually had the extra rounds if I needed it and nobody was the wiser. The gun itself, really a nice gun. It's got an elevation adjustable sight. Usually they're pretty bang on side to side, so the windage isn't a factor there. It is a 3-dot, so as you can see, you've got, you know, dot, dot, dot. And I love those for quick target acquisition. In addition, it has a loaded chamber indicator, so when you've got a round in there, this pops up. It's a nice little red flag, lets you know if it's loaded. Honestly, if you treat every gun like it's loaded, this is not a big deal, but it is kind of just a nice feature for everybody else. I do like the front and back slide serrations. The SR9 does not have them on the front. It's also going to be about an inch or so longer in the front. It does have a rail system on the front, so you can put on a lighter laser if you choose. It's ambidextrous on the safety, and it's kind of a 1911 style, which I like. I'm a big fan of the 1911. And then it's also ambidextrous on the magazine release. It is not ambidextrous on the slide release, however, so if you're left-handed, that might be a downside for you. The gun breaks apart really easy. You just cock it back, safety off, lock it up. What you'll do is there's a little pin down inside here. You flick that guy down, and then using something that's got a little bit of a point on it, you push this little nub out. Never use the feed lips of your magazines, because that's terrible. They're the most delicate part on your mag. But the corner on the base plate shouldn't be a problem. Anyway, that pops this plate out a little bit here. You just wiggle that out, like so. Okay, and then just drop the slide off, and bam, you're done. You pop out your spring, your barrel, and all that fun stuff, clean it accordingly. As you can see, this one's still full of oil, because it's brand new. So that is kind of a nice little thing. The gun itself is actually pretty darn accurate. I was kind of shocked at how accurate it was. At about 60 feet, so about 20 yards or so, I actually hit a head-sized head-sized target, and it was really accurate, and I did that in 2 shots. I was relatively impressed with it. This gun does have an exceptionally, well, not this gun, but the SR9C, it does have a double retained spring on the guide rod. So as such, it does take a lot of rounds to break it in. It's kind of unfortunate. So the one that I had, I broke in, sold it. This one I got it. I wanted to shoot it and mess with it, but honestly, once again, I need the money for some other projects a little bit more, so this guy's unfortunately going on the table, or on the docket, so it'll be sold. But the gun itself, absolutely flawless in functionality. It also does have the trigger safety built in here, so this gun is not going to just go off on accident. If you drop it and it's loaded and the safety's off, it won't go off. Now, with the original SR9, that was an issue, and that's actually why they started doing the trigger safety in there. And Ruger has amazing customer service, so they took care of it and took care of anybody who had the pre-trigger safety guns. They had them send it in, they paid for shipping both ways, and then sent back the gun with an extra magazine as an apology, and there was no cost to the consumers for it. So Ruger has a definite A-OK in my book for their customer service. The gun runs around $399 brand new. That's what we sell it for. So I apologize if the prices aren't that good in your area of the woods. But there are holsters for them. It also takes universal holsters pretty well. This gun, like I said, worked really well when I had the previous one. This one I'm assuming would work just as well, but like I said, it's going to go for sale just so I can get some more things for the show. But anyway, the gun itself, not for the price, it's outstanding. I still have a concealed carry for those of you who are concerned. I actually carry a Glock 19, and because I have the Glock 19, that's why this guy's being sold. The Glock 19 I got, I'll have to review it. It's actually one of the new ones that they released with the flat dark earth, or the desert earth brown on the grip, the frame, and then this black slide. It's going to be really slick, and I'll have to demo it and show some reviews on that. But for right now, the SR9C, like I said, that's the one that's going to take the hit, unfortunately. The gun itself is actually very slim, which is part of the reason why it's so popular, is because it is just a very slim and yet very reliable gun, very, very comfortable. So definitely, if money is an issue, the Rugers are absolutely some of the best price points and the best quality for the price. I would definitely give this one, out of 10 stars, I'd give this probably an 8 overall. I don't like the fact that when you first get it, it's really, really going to be a tough spring and it has to have a lot of break-in. Other than that, the gun itself, versatile and reliable and accurate, and the price you cannot beat. So hope that that helped anybody who had any questions about it or considering it. The SR9C, enjoy, and like I said, if you get the means, you know, pick one up. I would love to keep this guy, but ammo's going up in cost, so I've got limited rounds to put through it, and so I just figure I'll stick with my Glock 19 and call that good. So until next time.